And let's move on to Bobby. What's Elaine going to say?
Well, I don't know. She sometimes she leaves me alone, but I have a terrific sense of humor. She has a good sense of humor. And she can always deal with my funny bone. So I think...
Am I right bone connected to my left bone? Am I right bone connected to my...
Chris, and I'm also a volunteer teacher's aide.
Do you like to play password?
I love it.
Would you like to do it? We're all ready to do it. Here, I mean, play password, that is. Okay. All right, here we go. Oh, I like this. Oh, this is nice. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a fave. Render Cella.
Once upon a time in a foreign country, there was a beautiful girl. Her name was Render Cella. Now, Render Cella lived with her ugly other two Sigliesters. Also in the same corn country, there was a prance of hints. And he was going to have a fancy fall. So, Render Cella just cat down and Sarai. She's kidding her Sarai, and there appeared before her her Gary Mud father. And he touched with his magic man. And there appeared before Render Cella Kig Boach and Hicks White sources to take her to the Bansy Fall. Now Render Cella arrives at the Bansy Fall, and the Prancer Hints met at the door because he'd been watching behind a wooden hinder. Well, they danced all night, and they lullaby fub. And just as she beats the rottum, she slopped her dripper. This Prancer Hints is going all over this foreign country, looking for the beautiful girl that slopped her dripper. Finally, Prancer Hints arrives at Render Cella's house and tried on Mug Death in a fit and dip. Tried on Render Cella in a fit dip. It was exactly the sight rise. Now Render Cella and the Prancer Hints, they got married and lived happily after happer. Now the story of the morning is this. If you're going to a Bansy Fall and you want a lot of fub with the Prancer Hints, don't forget to slop your dripper.
All right, ready? I got it, Render. There you come, Render Cella. All right. Good going, Steve. Jay Farr, what do you think of Render Cella?
Definitely the man of J.P. Morgan's dreams. I give her a, give him a 10.
Good score. Harry Johnson.
10.
Another
marvelous.
10.
Brilliant.
Christine Mordone.
I give his tongue a 9.
That gives you 29 points. Thank you, Render.
Noel,
Charles.
I wrote that mouth too.
Charles and Christine are waiting for
me. I don't like this one.
All right, everybody's in. Marley? At the cannibal Halloween party, instead of bobbing for apples, they bob for...
Skulls?
Skulls? Boy, is it menacing when he says that, isn't it? Skulls? Okay, skulls.
Is this a Halloween party, Bert?
Yes, it is. It's a Halloween
party. Well, can I do my Herman Munster impression?
You bet.
Now, Grandpa. Okay. I think the answer, Eddie.
What's the answer? We're looking for skulls.
Missionaries.
No, that's not what they're bobbing for. Marsha, we're looking for skulls. This is important. 2 points here.
I don't have skulls.
I'll never win the home game.
I don't have skulls. Built like I am.
I don't believe it.
I figured they would bob for boobs. That's very strange.
Bob for boobs. It'll be
they weren't that hungry. They were bobbing all day, so they just wanted fingers.
They bobbed for fingers?
Okay. Thank you.
The Cannibal Halloween Party, instead of bobbing for apples, they bob for...
Harley said, heads, which is skulls?
Heads? Yes, they gave it to you. Skulls or heads. Okay, Jerry.
She doesn't want to show hers to
and
see.
And she really shouldn't
have
to.
I'll show mine. I don't think she should show her. I matched him. Missionaries.
Missionaries.
Yeah, I had missionaries.
What do you got?
I don't
you don't want to know, Bert.
It's not a match. Trust us.
It's not a match.
We have to show it. It's part of the game. Now I know why she doesn't want to.
Hey, Terry.
Okay.
Terry.
This one, no.
Terry, wait a minute.
We're gonna have this framed in the Match Game Hall of Fame.
Oh, wait, no. Terry. Terry, I'm having a Halloween party on the
phone. Okay, Michelle.
When Ugly Edna went to the doctor said, "Forget about the heart transplant, Ugly Edna. What you need is a blank transplant."
Head.
Head. The audience is groaning a little bit.
Yeah.
And
what did he say?
He said a head transplant.
A head transplant. Maybe I should take up the bicycle. That's what I said. A head transplant.
Right. A head transplant. Well, that surprises the heck out of me. I had one answer in my, it's just stuck in my face, and it surprised me to hear another answer. What'd you say?
Me too, hon.
What was your answer?
I thought the operative word was...
ugly.
Yeah. Thanks. I said face or punim.
Face.
What does that mean?
That means face.
Face.
Jewish.
What do you say?
Look, I also said, well, I said puss.
All right. Another face answer.
Right. That's all it
Come
is.
On. Come
no
on, Jimmy. Pass it down here. Nonsense.
Okay, What this is, actually there are still some little black hairs in here.
That was a line rat.
If you've got a tired pussy, cat, and you wanted to take your cat on a trip, wanted to take your cat.
Hey, Jimmy, wait a minute, Jimmy. Jimmy, you got
good night.
If you got change for a dollar over there, I just wondered if you had some change.
You wanted to take your pussy on a trip. You would put your cat in here. There's a door that goes on it, and it's a cat carrier for Pete's sake.
Oh, yeah. Not for my sake. It'll work not till I get finished, Jimmy. Well,
see the black hands in there?
Actually, John.
They were Shannons before they were bleached.